Welcome.
Family, Movies Brief here.
Today, I'm going to explain a Chinese sci-fi film called The Revenge of Plant. Spoilers ahead, watch out, and take care. The movie begins at the University of Qingshan. Professor Huo Yuchun and his assistant, Zheng Wen, are teaching a class about genetic engineering. The students take pictures of the board to go through the notes later. One of them, named Luo Kei, takes a picture of Zheng Wen instead. She has had a crush on him since she was a freshman, but has never had the courage to confess. Luo Kei's best friend, Lily, shows her the picture of a freshman's dead body that was found in their college that morning. They dismiss it as a rumor and continue with the class. Somewhere else, the police take pictures of the student who died mysteriously. His body has turned green, almost as if he was drugged. When everyone leaves the class, Luo Kei hands Zheng Wen a plant and confesses her love for him. Zheng Wen, however, rejects her because she is a student. Luo Kei expresses her frustration to Lily and says that she has never been rejected before. Her friend suggests she let it go and makes her dance to a song playing on the radio. Zheng Wen sees them dancing and smiles to himself. Following that, Luo Kei's classmate, who is in love with her, approaches her with a bouquet of flowers. Lily leaves them alone and goes to her dorm room. To her surprise, her face is covered with green pimples that look like budding plants. Puberty looks different in China. She quickly covers them with makeup. Luo Kei rejects the guy and makes her way to the dorm room. Meanwhile, Zheng Wen and Professor Huo Yuchun are in the professor's office. The professor offers him a drink that makes him go unconscious. Then he brings out a strange plant with glowing roots and injects a liquid extracted from it into Zheng Wen's body. He is trying to see if Zheng Wen's body is suitable for the plant to grow inside of it, but the match comes out 0%. The professor leaves the plant and Zheng Wen in his office and disappears. Back in the dorm room, Luo Kei notices Lily acting weird and asks her what is wrong. Lily doesn't show her face and just says that she needs to rest for a while. Luo Kei doesn't disturb her and starts to paint a picture of Zheng Wen. His balcony is visible from her window, which gives Luo Kei inspiration for the painting. Just like Romeo and Juliet, but with plant monsters. Somewhere else in the hostel, a girl hops in the shower. Above her, a creeping plant slowly covers the shower head. When she notices it, the water turns green, making her scream. After Luo Kei is done with the painting, she decides to give it to Zheng Wen, but when she knocks on his door, no one answers. Just then, a woman named Xu Men Luo approaches her and brings out a key from under the mat. She unlocks the door and asks her to wait inside. At the same time, Zheng Wen wakes up in the professor's cabin. He is confused as to why he fell asleep, but doesn't think much of it. He takes the plant and returns to his room. As the girls wait, Xu reveals that she is Zheng Wen's ex-girlfriend and they went to university together. Luo Kei is hit with a pang of jealousy, but she doesn't say anything. Xu leaves after a while, asking Luo Kei to tell Zheng Wen she was here. After she leaves, Luo Kei goes through Zheng Wen's belongings and tries different passwords for his computer. Okay, what is going on with stalker culture in all of these movies? Soon after, he arrives and is shocked to see her inside the room. Luo Kei tells him how she got inside and asks him why her birth date is the password to his computer. Ooh, never mind, they're both stalkers. Zheng Wen pretends to not know what she is talking about, so Luo Kei also shows him a picture of her and Lily on his computer. He takes her to his balcony and shows her the plants she has given him throughout the years. Zheng Wen then brings up Xu Men Luo and explains how he was in love with her, but she got an offer to work for a foreign company and dumped him. Luo Kei tries to hide her jealousy, but fails. She runs away from him, but he catches up and says that he too likes her, but since they are teacher and student, he thought the relationship wouldn't be appropriate. Luo Kei suggests they date after she graduates, and Zheng Wen agrees. He gives her the plant that he had gotten from the professor's office as a token of promise. After returning to her room, Luo Kei waters the plant, but the leaves cut her finger in the process. She simply puts a band-aid over it while talking to Lily. When her friend doesn't reply, she assumes that she slept early and goes to sleep herself. The roots of the plant start to glow in the dark. Its branches crawl down to the floor and take over Luo Kei's bed, strangling her in the process. Luo Ke wakes up to realize that it was just a bad dream. Then, she notices green liquid dripping from Lily's bed. She carefully removes the curtains and discovers Lily's dead body. Plants have begun to sprout from her back. The sight makes Luo Ke scream in fear. Soon, the news travels around, and the police are called to investigate. Zheng Wen finds out about the incident and runs to see if Luo Ke is okay. The police officer shows Zheng Wen a plant that was found in Lily's body and asks for his expert advice. Zheng Wen is confused because the plant looks like a gymnosperm, but has a kind of root that he has never seen in his life. While waiting for the police to be done, Luo Ke sees Xu in the crowd. Zheng Wen then takes her to the canteen to feed her something, since she hasn't eaten since the morning. It is announced that the university premises will go into a complete lockdown because of a virus that has been discovered in some of the students. All the students and teachers are asked not to leave the university without permission. When Luo Ke and Zheng Wen walk out of the building, Luo Ke hallucinates about plants taking over the university, but quickly comes back to reality. At the cafeteria, they hear the news about Professor Huo's disappearance. He is accused of endangering public health by introducing his students to a deadly virus. Luo Ke remembers that Lily has a boyfriend who she called H, who helped her pay for her tuition. She believes that H had something to do with her death. She then goes to the washroom where the band-aid from her finger moves, showing that the cut has started to grow a plant out of it. She panics and plucks it out. A man in a PPE set and face mask approaches her and Zheng Wen and asks them to go to the gymnasium as soon as possible to get tested and decontaminated. An announcement is made throughout the university, asking everyone to gather in the gymnasium. Policemen surround the premises, wearing poison masks, which scares the students even more. On their way to the gymnasium, they come across Xu Man Luo, who reveals that she is a professional called to investigate the cases of infection. She represents a multi-millionaire pharmaceutical company and has been working closely with Professor Huo for a synthetic gene reorganization research project. She found out that the professor's experiments deviated from the scientific research ethics. He started to reorganize animal and plant genetics to create harmful viruses. When she confronted him, he dismissed her and didn't stop the experiments. He even started to use his students as test subjects, which caused the outbreak of the virus. As Xu and Zheng Wen talk about the experiments, Luo Ke notices her nerves turning green. She registers that she has been infected by the virus and runs away to hide. Zheng Wen notices after some seconds and starts to look for her. Meanwhile, the girl who was attacked by plants earlier is restrained by the officers for being infected. She is given medical assistance, but the virus kills her eventually. Zheng Wen goes to his room and finds Luo Ke there. She asks him to stay away and shows him the infected arm. He also notices that her face is glowing green. Luo Ke then opens Lily's MySpace. Wow, these guys are behind the times. And reads the notes that she used to write every day. The note mentions a man named H, who used to take her to his house that had a view of a lighthouse. She also talks about a plant that H gave her as a gift. They assume that H is none other than Professor Huo himself. Just then, some men in PPE suits come to the dorms to disinfect the hallways. They ask anyone who is still inside the room to come out. Zheng Wen and Luo Ke are scared that if they find out Luo Ke is infected, they will make her the test subject of their experiments. Therefore, they decide to hide until the men leave. However, Luo Ke accidentally drops a glass of water and gives away her presence. The men take both of them to the gymnasium to test them. After finding out that Luo Ke is infected, they sedate her with a tranquilizer and take her away. Later, a group of officials interrogates Xu Man Luo about the virus. She briefs them that the virus can affect a human's brain and nervous system. However, it isn't contagious and can only transmit through direct contact with the infected plant. The officials assume that this means the cases of infection are similar to poisoning and there is nothing to worry about. According to Xu, Luo Ke's genetics are very well matched to give rise to a new form of variable of the virus that might be extremely dangerous, even though it is not contagious. The men are terrible at their jobs and do not take her warnings seriously and decide that they are going to lift the lockdown. Outside, Zheng Wen meets Xu Man Luo, and the two decide to go to the place that Lily talked about in her journal. They assume that the place is the professor's lab, where they can find more information about the experiments he performed on the students. They finally reach the house and see it has been taken over by the plants. The professor is sitting motionless on a chair. When the two approach him, a gigantic Venus flytrap emerges from his back and almost kills them. Xu Manluo lights the plant on fire and kills the professor alongside it. Then, she goes through the professor's computer and finds out that if the virus's growing condition matches 100% with someone's genetics, it will give rise to a never-dying plant that will grow at an exponential rate and can cover cities, if not countries. Similarly, if 0% of the genetics match, then the person would be immune to the virus altogether. At the beginning of the movie, Zheng Wen's genetics had matched 0%, explaining the reason he hadn't been infected, even though the professor injected him with the virus directly. Xu Manluo tries to receive data from the computer to send it back to the company she works for. Zheng Wen is against it, since a lot of people have died because of the experiment, and the information might put more lives in danger. When he stops her, Xu Manluo attacks him with pepper spray. Before she can run away, a branch grows from the Venus flytrap and kills her. Back in the gymnasium, we see that Luo Ke's genetics have matched 100% suitable for the virus's growth. Like the professor had predicted, she starts to grow a never-ending, dense crawler plant from her body and takes over the gymnasium. The medical professionals helping her are also killed in the process. When Zheng Wen returns to the university, he finds everyone dead, but Luo Ke is nowhere to be found. We are then shown that the entire city has been taken over by the plant. Several months after the incident, Zheng Wen returns to the university, still looking for Luo Ke. He notices the painting that she made of him on the classroom's wall. In the final scene, Zheng Wen looks behind him and smiles, presumably because he saw Luo Ke. Subscribe for more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you.